G'day, I'm Steve Shears and welcome to Vladivostok, the major city in the Russian Far East. The name Vladivostok means ruler of the East and staked Russia's claim to this side of the continent. With winter temperatures getting down to around minus 10 degrees centigrade, many of the cars here are four-wheel drive. About 90% come across from Japan as second-hand vehicles. And there are a lot of Delicas driving around, so maybe I made the right vehicle choice for the trip. We all went down to the railway station, the end of the line for the Trans-Siberian Railway. 9,288 kilometres to Moscow, though our route will take us much further than that. The train only takes 6 days to complete the trip, and we are allowing 90. The railway construction began in 1891 and finished in 1913. Vladivostok was only settled in the 1860s and is not yet 150 years old. From the 1930s through to 1992, it was a closed town and even Russian citizens weren't allowed in. This was because the naval base for the Pacific Fleet was here and is still here today. Indeed, there is much naval history here, like the submarine C-56, which sunk 14 ships. It was also the first submarine to circumnavigate the globe. Today, we had a cruise around the harbour. On our flight up to Vladivostok, we flew via South Korea and spent a night in Seoul. In the streets were hundreds of trucks parked, on strike over the high cost of fuel. In shipping our cars to Russia, they changed ships in Busan, Korea, and needed to be transported from one dock to another. The next day we were expecting the cars to arrive. We visited the shipping company, and because of the strike, they say either next Monday or Thursday. Though I know this will probably mean Thursday. And then allowing a few days to clear customs will mean we'll be stuck here for another week. We'll be really pushing to get to Ulaanbaatar in time for the festival. Today we met Alona and Anya, a couple of university students who took us on an adventurous tour of their city. We visited a little church which was rebuilt after the Stalin era and replaced by a main church. We climbed a hill overlooking the city and got a magnificent view of the Golden Harbour.
Okay, so we wait here.
At dinner, Anya carefully explained each Russian dish. But I don't think the hungry crowd behind were all that impressed. Faced with another week delay, we have decided to catch the train up to Khabarovsk and spend a few days looking around.